Hello guys, so today in this video we are going to cover class 11th chapter 1 sets of class 11th math. So we have started the series of class 11th math, so then follow that series. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and do not forget to hit the bell icon so that you may have notifications of my all videos. So let's start the video. Set. Introduction of set is, introduction is this. A set is a well-defined collection. A set is a collection of well-defined distinguished objects. The sets are usually denoted by capital letters, which is A to Z. Means A, B, C, etc. and etc. A, B, C, X, Y, Z, etc. And the members or elements of the set are denoted by lowercase letters. Means A, B, C, X, Y, Z, etc. If X is a member of the set A, we write X belongs to A. So let us set A is equals to X, Y, and Z. So by this X belongs to Z. Sorry, X belongs to A and Y belongs to A and Z belongs to A. So this symbol A represent belongs to. So read as X belongs to A, what I tell you. And if X is not the member of set A, so then we call X does not belongs to A. This symbol represents does not belongs to, and it is read as X does not belongs to A. If X and Y both belong to A, we write X comma Y belongs to A. This represents both belongs to A. Some examples of sets are A odd, let us set A odd numbers less than 10. So this set is equals to 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. Because this is in less than 10. And N, the set of all rational numbers. And B, the vowels in the English alphabets, means A to Z. Q, the set of all rational numbers. Here N is equals to Q. So this is only introduction. Let know more about set. We can represent the set in two methods. Set builder form, which is also called rule method, and roster form, which is also called tabular form. So let the know set builder form or rule method. So in this form, we write a variable, say X, representing any member of the set, followed by properties satisfied by each member of the set, e.g. the set of A of all prime numbers less than 10 in set builder form is written as this type. This symbol stands for the word such that, and it is represented by curly brackets. These brackets are known as curly brackets. So X, such that X is a prime number less than 10, and the word I tell you that this symbol stands for the word such that. Sometimes we use symbol this also in the place of this symbol. So both the symbols stands for the word such that. So let know about roster form or tabular method. So in this form, we first list all the members of the set within braces, means curly brackets, and separate these by commas. Example, the set of all natural numbers less than 10 in this form is written as A equals to 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, as I told you. In roster form, every element of the set is listed only once. The order in which elements are listed is immaterial. An example, each of the following sets denotes the same set. The position of the elements does not matter here. 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, 1, 3, 2. Position here no matters. Let's know about subsets. Let A and B be two sets. If every element of A is an element of B, then A is called a subset of B and written as A is a subset of B. This symbol stands for the word subset. A is a subset of B and this symbol stands for the word superset. So we write it as A is a subset of B or B is a subset of B is a superset of A. Read as A is contained in B or B contains A. B is called superset of A. Here notes are these. Every set is a subset and superset of itself, as I told you. If A is not a subset of B, then we write it as this symbol stands for the word is not a subset of. And third one is the empty set is the subset of every set. I will tell you the empty set about in some time. Fourth, if A is a subset, A is a set with n of A is equals to m, then number of elements A equals to 2 power n. This stands for number of elements in set A equals to m. A are 2n, 2 power n, and the number of proper subsets is equals to of A are 2 power n minus 1, because one set is nothing, which is 5. Example, let A is a set 3, 4. Then subsets of A are 5. This symbol 3, 4 and 3, 4. Here number of elements in A equals to 2 and number of subsets of A equals to 2 power 2, which is equals to 4. So let's know about types of sets. Types of sets are empty set, which is also called null set, singleton set, finite set or infinite set, and equivalent set. And one is equal set. So let us know about equal set. So two sets A and B are said to be equal if written as A equals to B. If every element of A is in B and every element of B is in A, means let a set A 1, 2, 3, 4 and B is 3, 1, 4, 2, then every element of A is in set B, because they go, see, 1, 2, 3, 4 here and 1, 2, 3, 4 here, then A equals to B. Second, X such that X minus 5 equals to 0 and B equals to X such that X is an integral positive root of the equation X square minus 2X minus 15 equals to 0. So let us know the values of X. So X minus 5 equals to 0. So here X is equals to 5. And in the quadratic equation X square minus 2X minus 15, it is equals to X minus 5 into X plus 3. So this is equals to minus 5 and minus 3. So minus 3 is not positive root. So this is incorrect. So the value is minus 5 and 5. So in this case 5 is yes. So then set A is equals to set A. So set A and B are equal set. Let us know about finite and infinite set. Finite and infinite set are this. A set which has finite number of elements is called a finite set. Otherwise it is called a infinite set. Example, the set of all days in a week is a finite set, because there are Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. There are 7 days: Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday and Saturday. These are the 7 days in a week. So this number is finite. So this set is also finite. So the set of natural numbers is an infinite set. Means 1, 2, 3, 4. It never ends. So this is an infinite set. So an empty set 5, which has no element, is a finite set. Set A is called empty or void or null set. So let us know about equivalent set. Equivalent set is this: two finite sets A and B are said to be equivalent if n of A, means number of elements in set A, is equals to number of elements in set B. Clearly, equal set are equivalent, but equivalent set need not to be equal. Let a set A 4, 5, 3, 2 and a set B 1, 6, 8, 9. So here number of elements in A equals to 4 and B, and in B also 4. So these sets are equivalent but not equal. So let us take an example 2, 3, 4, 5 and a set 4, 5, 3, 2. These sets are equivalent and equal to. So these are equivalent sets and equal sets also. So let us know about singleton set. So a set having one element is called a singleton set. Example, 0 is a singleton set whose only member is 0. A, let us set A x such that x lies between 1 and 3. So x is a natural number. So it is a singleton set because it has only one number, which is 2. So let us know about empty set. Empty set is this: a set which has no element is called a null set. It is denoted by symbol phi or this symbol. Means a set which has no elements. Example, set of all real numbers whose square is minus 1. Because it is an empty set, because in real numbers there is no number whose square is minus 1. In set builder form, it is equals to x such that x is a real number whose square is minus 1. And in roster form is this set, as I tell you, the set which has no element or 5. So let us know about cardinal number. It is cardinal number. So the number of elements is in a finite set is represented by n of A. As I told you before, it is equals to number of elements in set A, known as cardinal number. Example, let us set A B C D E. So then number of elements in set A is equals to 5. So it is all in this video. We meet in next video. So stay tuned and subscribe to my channel. So this is lecture 1 and next is lecture 2. Sets, the chapter set is complete, will be completed in the next lecture, which is lecture 2. Then we will do some questions of R.D. Sharma Math. So stay tuned and bye. Thanks for watching this video.